Which parent should fill out the FAFSA when divorced or separated? There are some new guidelines rolling out for the 24-25 year that you need to know about. Hey everyone, I'm Tina Steele, the FAFSA guru, and if you like what I have to say, be sure to subscribe to my channel by clicking the link below. There are some big changes coming to the 24-25 FAFSA, and one of those changes is related to which parent should fill out the form when they're divorced or separated. Under current guidelines, the parent with whom the child resided with most within the last year or the custodial parent is technically the one that should be filling out the FAFSA on behalf of the child when divorced or separated. Under the new regulations that go into effect for the 24-25 FAFSA that gets released this year, that is changing. The parent that needs to fill out the FAFSA on behalf of the dependent child when divorced or separated is going to be the parent who provides more than half of that child's financial support, regardless of whether or not that parent is the custodial or non-custodial parent, and also regardless of whether or not the child lives with that parent. It does not matter which parent claims a child on their taxes. What you need to think about is which parent is providing more than half of that child's financial support. That's a big change coming that's going to have a significant impact on a lot of families. In a lot of situations when parents are divorced or separated, the custodial parent or the parent with whom the child lives with the most is the one that has the lower income, which is beneficial when it comes to filling out the FAFSA form. That's no longer going to be the case under these new guidelines, unfortunately. And it's also important to mention that the 24-25 FAFSA is getting released late this year. Typically, that form opens up October 1st for completion, but because of all the big changes happening to the new FAFSA, the government announced recently that it's not going to be released until sometime in December. This will have a really significant impact on students who are applying early action or early decision, because usually they receive those financial aid offers in mid to late December, but whereas the FAFSA is not even opening until then, it's going to be probably February before students start hearing about their financial aid offers. I do have another video about this on my YouTube site if you want to learn more about it. And if you're a high school senior or a rising high school senior, or you're the parent of one, I highly encourage you to check out my FAFSA and Financial Aid Academy. This is my signature program. I run it every single year from September through May for parents of high school seniors and high school seniors to help you successfully navigate the overwhelming and confusing financial aid process and maximize your financial aid offers. There's three different levels of service that you can choose from depending on how closely you want to work with me. And two of those levels fill up really fast because I have to cap enrollment to ensure providing quality services to the families who are enrolled. You can learn more about this program on my website, thefafsaguru.com. You can also learn more about the other programs and services I provide. And for anyone that I've never worked with before, you can set up a free 10-minute consultation call with me on my website, and I'd be happy to answer any questions that you might have. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks so much for watching.